Good morning student, myself Pankaj Kumar and welcome to my class. In last video we had solved some question from exercise 13.1. Today we are going to discuss how to find distance when we have speed and time. So let's start. So we know the formula speed equal to distance by time. Using this formula only we can find out the formula for distance and time. So let's see how to find the formula. So speed by 1 we can write. Then distance by time. Okay, so this formula we can write like this: speed by 1 equal to distance by time. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to do the cross multiplication. Okay, that means s into t give equal to then d into 1. So we can write d only. Okay, then d equal to s into t. Okay, so this is the formula: distance equal to speed into time. Okay, this is how we can find out the formula for distance. Same way we can find out for time. See, s by 1 equal to d by t. Okay, now do the cross multiplication. Then s into t equal to d into 1 d. Okay, now we have to find out the formula for time. So time equal to d by this s will come here. Okay, so this is the formula to find time and this is to find distance. Okay, now let's see the example. So how much distance will a bag travel in 2 hours at a speed of 80 km per hour? So we have here distance covered in 1 hour is equal to 80 km, or this is the speed we can say 80 km per hour. Okay, so distance covered in 1 hour is equal to 80 km. That means the bike can travel 80 km in 1 hour. Okay, the distance covered in 2 hour equal to 2 into 80. Okay, speed into time. So time we have 2 hours, and 80 is the speed here. So 2 into 80 160 km. Okay, and distance covered in 2 hour equal to 160 km. Answer. Okay, so distance equal to, just now we have seen here the formula, distance equal to time into speed. So we have the time here 2 hour, and the speed we have 80 km per hour. Okay, so simply what we have to do, we have to multiply. Okay, distance equal to speed into time. So this is the speed, 80 km per hour, and this is the time. When we multiply, we'll get here 160 km. This is the answer. Okay, same way the formula for time equal to distance by speed. Sorry, spelling mistake here. Okay, so this is the formula to find speed, time equal to distance by speed. Okay, distance by speed. Let's see the example. How much time will a bus take to cover a distance of 490 km at a speed of 70 km per hour? So we have here distance 490 km, distance to cover 490 km, speed we have 70 km per hour. We have to find out time. Okay, so time taken equal to distance by speed. Time taken equal to distance by speed. So we have this distance 490 km divided by speed we have 70 km per hour. When we reduce the term, 00 cancel. Now 7 1 7 7 7 49. Okay, 7 hour, this is the answer. Here you can see distance or distance we have in kilometer, and speed also we have in kilometer, so no need to change anything. Okay, simply we have to use the value and we have to divide to get the answer. Understood? Now let's see the another example. How long will Sonu take to run a 300 meter race if his speed is 20 km per hour? ओके 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो सोनू डिस्टेंस वी हैव 300 मीटर, डिस्टेंस वी हैव 300 मीटर एंड स्पीड वी हैव 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर, 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द टाइम हियर ऑल्सो, बट बिफोर दैट हियर यू हैव टू सी वी हैव द डिस्टेंस इन मीटर एंड वी हैव अ स्पीड इन किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वी हैव टू चेंज दिस स्पीड इन टू मीटर पर सेकेंड. ओके हियर यू कैन सी वी हैव द डिस्टेंस इन मीटर बट हियर वी हैव द स्पीड इन किलोमीटर पर आवर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस वी हैव टू चेंज दिस वन into meter per second. Okay, meter per second, understood? So first we have to convert this, and you know very well how to convert. 20 into we will multiply by 5 by 18. Okay, 20 we will multiply by 5 by 18. Now reduce the term, 2 9 18 and 2 10 20. Okay, when we multiply 10 by 5 we'll get 50 by 9 meter per second. Okay, now you can see here also meter and here also meter, understood? Meter per second. Now easily we can calculate. So time equal to distance by speed, you know very well. So distance we have 300 meter and speed we have 50 by 9. Okay, this 9 will go up here. Now reduce the term, 0 0 cancel, 5 1 5 5 6 30. Okay, so we have 6 into 9. When we multiply we'll get 54 second answer. This is the answer. Okay, so this is how we have to solve this problem. So children, today whatever I have discussed with you, I hope each and everything is clear to you. Thank you.